Welcome back. So in this video, I'll be going over customizing the Revit menu options. Obviously, there is a lot of different things you can do here. We'll start off by selecting a new project using the new model command and selecting architectural template. So this project will be saved as an RBT file eventually. So when you first start Revit for the first time, you'll see the properties and the project browser are on the left-hand side. What you can do as a best practice is to pull them apart and dock the properties on the right-hand side. As long as the window is maximized, you can do that, right? So this way you can see a whole list of things under properties and a list of things under the project browser. So I recommend that very highly. All right, so you can also adjust the size of the window any way you want, as long as the text is readable. There's no problem there. Under the File pull-down menu, you can access File, New, File, Open. You can open a project or a family or a point cloud. You can do a save as project or save as template. You can also save to a library. You can save as a family or as a group. You can export your file to a CAD format such as DWG or DXF. Also use that for printing and what have you. Under File Options is really where our main focus today would be, is where we can modify things such as under the general options, we look under the save intervals. I like to set that more frequently, like every 15 minutes. Your username is set by the login name on the top right of the screen. You can also adjust the journal file. Journal file have to do with Revit. It keeps keep track of every click and pick you make, and records that in a journal file, a text file. So this would be useful for you to provide to your Autodesk service provider in order to help you to troubleshoot any problems with file corruption. In case you are working with work sharing or multi-user environment, you can adjust the frequency of the update for work sharing. When it comes to the view options, you can start every view with a architectural or under coordination or other disciplines as well. Under user interface or the UI, on the top of the screen, the ribbon screen, you have, sorry, on the top of the ribbon menu, you have the architectural, structural systems, and you can turn off or turn on any of those menus manually over here, right? So, for example, if you're an architect and not using electrical or plumbing options, you can turn this off, right? You also want to every time you make a change, you want to click OK to accept those changes. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to come back and turn on my structural, and I'm going to turn on certain things that I use on a regular basis, right? Such as energy analysis and structural. All right, keyboard shortcuts. You can customize your keyboard shortcuts. You can search for the command by name, such as the copy command, right? So the keyboard shortcut for copy is CO or CC. So if you are a keyboard person, you type very fast, like 1,000 words per minute, then you could leverage that as so you can after you customize your keyboard shortcuts, you can export them and have them available for other people in your office. When it comes to double click options, double click by default in this version of Revit will allow you to edit the family. I really don't like that because many times we double click on a door by mistake. So I want Revit to do nothing when I double click on something. You have to be careful what you ask for, right? This is one of the things on the wish list of the knowledge network or the user group. There are other miscellaneous options you can also customize, but right now I want to disable the double click. Also, on the ribbon tab switching, I would like the idea of having it to stay on the modify tab. In other words, every time you hit escape on the keyboard, the menu goes back to the modify menu, okay? Not the previous menu, the modify menu, because it's the one that's mostly used. You can have a dark theme or a light theme right on the top, the dark ribbon. And if you have a good graphics card, you can enable the graphics acceleration. When it comes to the graphics options, usually Revit comes with a blue color for the selection and the pre-selection. What I like to do is I like to change the pre-selection to magenta, so that they're different than each other. It can be red or any other color, but just make the pre-selection different than the selection. Hardware options, file locations is very important, right? So this is the path. This shows the path of the Imperial Library, Imperial templates of Revit. So in case you are working in an office environment and you want to put those on the server somewhere, as a BIM manager, you could change the path on every computer, like create an image. And then reroute all that to a different location. The default path for user files is under documents. If you want to put your local files in a specific folder, you can create a Revit file, a Revit folder over there and put it there. Default path for family templates. We typically use English Imperial in the United States, so it was good to know where it is located, including the conceptual mass family. Point clouds also has its own path, and then of course HVAC and energy files are located in this fold, in this path. Now the customization part of this has to do with clicking on the places command, places menu, and then selecting giving it a name, and the name is My Project for now. And selecting a path on the right-hand side and locating a folder, right? And then giving it a name, and the name would be My Project. Okay? So if you have more than one project, you can have more than one shortcut. I'm gonna try this again. And here's the folder. Okay. So it's good to have that, because if you work on multiple projects, you can access the, when you go to the open command, this shortcut will appear under your Windows shortcut under My Project. So you may have project one, project two, project three, as many as you are working on. Very useful thing to do. I highly recommend that. Under rendering, you can, if you have other additional rendering libraries, you can specify where that is located. Spell checking is kind of a straightforward thingy, right? You may want to check the box to ignore words in uppercase. That's an optional thing. Unless you name your sheets uppercase, then don't check the box. Steering wheel and view cube, sometimes they're just too strong on the screen, so you may want to change the opacity for those to 25%. Okay. Same thing for the view cube, 25% opacity. And under macros, you may want to disable macros unless you specifically use macros for something on your project. So disable macros is a good practice. So that's that was it as far as Revit file options. The other thing you can do to customize your UI or user interface is to work with the quick access toolbar. The quick access toolbar is a Windows function that either appeared on the top of the ribbon menu or at the bottom of the ribbon menu. By the way, the ribbon menu was designed by Microsoft, so Autodesk is licensed to use that. So you could right click on any command, add to the quick access toolbar, and right click remove from the quick access toolbar. You can also decide to show the quick access toolbar above the ribbon menu or below the ribbon menu. Also, the ribbon menu can appear to be minimized or maximized depending on how you want that to appear. So just click on that button on the far right of the menu to toggle the different menu options. Okay, so there may be other things that you can do here. This is the option bar. The option bar, is specific to the wall command. In this case, when you go to the door command, it changes the option bar. Okay, so you could right click on it and show below the desktop or above. Right, so that's an option for you. So you can right click and on the panel and then show title or no title. I like the title, it helps a little bit. Also, what can we do? We can also customize the properties. Right click and add to the quick access toolbar or add to the ribbon modify tab. Okay. So when you do that, this is the properties type selector. And right now it shows the floor plan. So if you're working with a door, for example, then you would see the door types in that menu. So I'm going to illustrate how that works for another family, not just for review. So I'm just going to create a quick wall and then add the door in there. Click the door, and then you can go to the right side, click on the properties, or the top on the modify menu, and you can see the type selector for doors. Hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching.